Uncle Ray Ray's got a game.
Hey, get your finger out of there.
Tickle, 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 tickle. Hey, you want to play with Uncle Ray? There's a little balloon animal. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da.
Yeah. That's right, babe. That's right, babe. That's right, babe.
Oh no, friends. Monkeypox now officially declared a worldwide emergency. Oh shit, what do I do? What do I do? Where do I go get my experimental vaccinations from Dolgate and Fauci? Oh man. There is definitely not going to be a connection between Dolgate and Fauci and AIDS and COVID and monkeypox. Don't look into it. Nothing to see here. He's definitely not in San Francisco doing research. But anyhow, what do I do? How do I protect myself? Is it airborne? Does it last on surfaces for 38 days, just like COVID? How will I ever make sure that I don't get the dirty, filthy monkeypox? Oh, I guess I just don't have filthy bathroom sex at a gas station. I'm sorry, okay, I'm fucking confused on what. Monkeypox is a worldwide global health emergency. It's the second pandemic, lads. But I can also avoid it by not banging randos with pus-filled penises behind an Arby's. How will I ever protect myself? 18 fucking booster shots, right? Holy shit, look at this. Look at this Democrat over here. And Democrat's all pissed off because he got AIDS and monkeypox, allegedly. I don't know about the AIDS. Definitely the monkeypox and gonorrhea. Well, how did it do it? Did the white supremacists do it? Probably, gateway pundit. Soros. Is it fucking Soros? Sores on his penis, more like. Sores on his penis. Open Society Foundation employee brags about having sex with multiple men at Pride event, then blames government after catching monkeypox and gonorrhea. That's a fucking lefty for you. That's a fight. Even not working at a George Soros Open Society Foundation, I would presume that you're a dumb fucking leftard if you went out, banged a bunch of weirdos with drippy dicks, and then you got sick. You're all shocked by this. Oh my God. Oh my.
And when Wesley Wallace says he's been dealing with monkeypox for 3 weeks now, and it's not over yet. We want to warn you, this illness is graphic in nature, and we do not want to hide the severity of some of its symptoms, but you should know some of these images are hard to watch. Wesley Wallace says just being awake,
it hurts to exist,
is excruciating.
As you can see, from the time it started, it's just progressed and gotten worse and worse.
It's right there on his face. What he first thought was just a pimple.
I was like, oh God, please not me, please not me.
Soon turned out to be monkeypox. 8 different lesions on his chin, even one inside his mouth.
Every sip, every bite, it's just like, oh, I can't, it hurts.
And it's spreading.
Now random little lesions are starting to appear on my body. So one on my hand, there's one here, like there on my wrist.
Wallace thinks he caught the virus at a bar July 4th weekend.
I'm going to say I probably was kissing somebody that had it and didn't know it, just based on where my initial lesions pop up.
But says access to the vaccine.
There's a huge high-risk population that is just hungry for the vaccine, and they don't have access to it.
Has been so scarce, his friends are leaving the state to get it.
I have friends that are actually buying airline tickets, flying to other cities, just go get the vaccine and then come home.
He says, along with the pain and the symptoms can come isolation.
The thing is, you look at it and it's such an ugly virus. You know, you look at it, you just recoil and you're like, oh, I don't want to be any.
A, B, C, D, E, F, you and your mom and your sister and your job and your
near that. I knew the stigma that might come with it, but I also know that lots of people are facing that stigma.
He has support, but wants others to know they're not alone.
Just let them know that they're not some kind of pariah, that they're not dirty.
You serious?
And that it's going to be okay. It's not lethal. It's just very temporary and it's scary for the moment.
How's everybody doing? My name is Anthony Brian Logan, and today we got to talk about CDC Director Rochelle Walensky letting the proverbial cat out of the bag as it relates to monkeypox. Who's spreading it? How is it being spread? And more. Now, I'll play that particular video in a little bit. If you want to see it without my commentary, the link, as always, will be in the description. But let's back up a little bit. What is monkeypox? What's going on? Why is it important? Well, monkeypox is some kind of virus or condition that causes really bad lesions all over your body. I'm not sure if it's lethal or whatever, but it's a really big thing that started in certain places in Europe. I'll talk about a little bit later. And the World Health Organization, the WHO, has declared monkeypox a global health emergency. Now, I'm not really sure why it's being classified as a global emergency when it's only one portion of the population, a very small slice, who are being affected. I'll talk about that a little bit later, but first, let's roll the clip.
COVID-19 pandemic rages on, growing concerns about monkeypox. The World Health Organization issuing its highest level of alert, declaring the monkeypox outbreak a global health emergency.
We have an outbreak that has spread around the world rapidly through new modes of transmission, about which we understand too little.
According to the CDC, there were less than two dozen cases in the U.S. last month. Today, there were nearly 2,900, including two children. Dr. Ashish Jha, CBS Face the Nation, saying U.S. health officials continue to assess the situation.
We are seeing outbreaks that are out of control in many, many parts of the world. It's very important that we get our arms around this thing.
The majority of the outbreak is currently concentrated in men who have sex with other men, but it can easily be transmitted to others.
We are seeing person-to-person transmission of this virus. It's spread through close, often intimate contact.
In recent decades, low levels of monkeypox have been reported in some African countries. The current outbreak is affecting countries across the globe. The virus is typically a mild illness that can cause fever, headache, fatigue, and pain.
Look, son, did you see the rainbow?
Wow.
Do you know what it means?
Gayness.
No, the devil hijacked its meaning and changed it.
What it means. I can only imagine.
We do have seen now two cases that have occurred in children. Both of those children are traced back to individuals who come from the men who have sex with men community, the gay men community. And so when we have seen those cases in children, they have generally been what I call adjacent to the community most at risk. I should also mention, importantly, those children are doing well.
As you can see, this is my room. It is like very similar to a hotel room. I have everything and nothing in this room actually goes out.
For 10 days, these four walls were all Haroon knew. Two doors isolated him from the outside world.
Every single bottle, every single paracetamol, every single IV, everything, all the needles, everything they use on me stays in this room.
He was rushed to the Royal Free Hospital in North London with a high fever, an early symptom of his monkeypox infection. Lesions and scabs in his throat meant Haroon couldn't eat or swallow. He was fed through a tube in his arm. It is one of the most extreme cases of monkeypox ever seen in the UK. Haroon has only just been discharged from hospital, but he is still in quarantine.
I am by myself alone. I don't have any family here, rather than my good couple of good friends. It was very scary. I thought that I'm by myself. I can't do this alone. And not being able to get help from frontline services was very scary.
Globally, there are more than 16,000 reported cases of monkeypox in at least 75 countries. Here in the U.S., the largest number of reported cases are in New York State, with 900.
And I have no idea. I had no idea that I had it.
An outward interview you'll only see on Local 10 News of one man's battle with monkeypox. The number of cases is on the rise across the country, with the highest concentration right here in South Florida. Local 10's Atzavella spoke with that patient about his painful experience. Hatzel is live at JMH with the exclusive tonight. Hatzel.
Calvin, this is a young man, 24 years old, and he tells me he was hospitalized here at Jackson Memorial for several hours. He's back home now, documenting what he is experiencing because he wants other people to know what to expect.
check to Memorial Hospital and notice this fire going on.
His video blog starts at the hospital and now continues at home for the sake of the public, he says. Jonathan Araujo shows us his lesions, the clear signs of monkeypox. By Zoom, he tells me,
it's serious. It's not just sexually transmitted. It's not a gay disease.
The 24-year-old bartender wants to erase the stigma. Anyone, he says, can get it.
I didn't get it from risky behavior. I got it
bullshit
from going clubbing with my friends and enjoying a good time.
He worries.
The devil is a motherfucking liar. So you know I ain't worried. Beyond.
People are in the dark. Even people in healthcare don't know enough.
I was sick with like a fever and like chills for like two days.
The fever, the chills, then broke. But days later, what looked like pimples came out.
I had them like.
All right, so you saw that, you heard that. Now, first things first, is it just me or was she very, very nervous in that clip? Very nervous. I'm talking about gun to her head, like just out of the frame. You couldn't see the pistol, but it was almost like she was a hostage or just trying to be very careful. And it's a shame because, I mean, I'm not going to sit here and try to defend Rochelle Walensky personally, but it's not even really about her. Do I like her? Do I not like her? It's a shame what's happened to the medical, I guess you would say, establishment, regular normies that work in the medical industry. You're being politicized. She knows where monkeypox is coming from. We knew where it came from the very beginning. It came from a bathhouse where men have sex with men over in Spain. And before I continue down that path, I just want to say that I have no hatred toward the LGBTQ community. Nothing at all. If you're a man and you want to lay with a man and y'all consent, that's your business, not my business.
Foundation, I would presume that you're a dumb fucking leftard if you went out, banged a bunch of weirdos with drippy dicks, and then you got sick. You're all shocked by this. Oh my God. Oh my God.